What's up, guys? RGT85 here, and today on the channel we have to talk about how the Nintendo Switch is officially doomed, because there's three new Doom games on the Nintendo Switch. I have always wanted to use that stupid title for a video, and this is the perfect opportunity to use that title. So yes, Doom, Doom 2, and Doom 3 dropped on the Nintendo Switch on Friday with a stealth drop, and honestly, Bethesda has kind of been in my doghouse lately. You know, I wasn't a big fan of Wolfenstein Youngblood. Make sure you guys go check out that video to see why. Of course, their E3 presentation was pretty stupid. I mean, Commander Keen is back, and he's not back in a good way, but this was actually some decent will by Bethesda to stealth drop these games. Of course, these also came out on the Xbox One and PS4, and it's great to have this trilogy of Doom games now on the Nintendo Switch, because, of course, the Nintendo Switch is a portable system, so to have these three games on there is very, very cool in my opinion. Now, you've heard some stuff going on about the DRM with Doom and Doom 2, especially on the Nintendo Switch, where you have to log into a Bethesda account in order to play these games, and a lot of people have been pissed off about that, but I want to show you guys a way that this becomes a non-issue. So we have the original Doom playing right here. I'm just going to exit out, and you can see that my Nintendo Switch is currently in airplane mode, which means that it is not accessing any sort of Wi-Fi or anything like that. It is completely offline. Now, it is stupid that I have to put my Nintendo Switch in offline mode in order to not be bombarded by the stupid DRM stuff, but if this works like it has been working, you're gonna see that this actually becomes a non-issue. I know some people have actually said that they keep having the DRM message pop up that you need to sign into your Bethesda account while playing this, but the only time I've experienced that is when playing the game with online on and putting it into sleep mode. When you put it into sleep mode and restart the game, it will start to pop up over and over again. But you can see that the game is trying to get me to turn off airplane mode. I say, no, we will not do that, and bam, I'm in the game. So it's not that big of a deal if you just turn on airplane mode. Now, as far as the actual port of Doom 1 is concerned, I do have a save game, but I'm just gonna start out with a new game because I feel like it sort of showcases my one problem that I really have with this game, and that is the music. Now, the music is, of course, heavily inspired by bands like Metallica, Pantera, Black Sabbath, and I've always loved the Doom music, but you can hear that the music is like slightly slower than it's supposed to be. And this is a great Metallica song that is now slightly slower than it should be sounding. So that's really weird to me. I don't really understand why the music is slower. We also have a problem with Doom 2's music as well. But that is something worth noting. That's probably the thing that bothers me the most, because I'm a big fan of bands like Metallica, Pantera, Black Sabbath, you know, metal bands like that. So to hear the slowed down music is a bit, you know, worrying. Like, they do need to sort of patch that or something, I feel. But you can see that the game itself looks absolutely beautiful. Like, yes, it's an older game, but that's not really indicative of what sort of version you're gonna get. Look at all the versions of Doom that came out during the heyday of Doom. You have, of course, had things like the Super Nintendo, the Sega 32X, the Atari Jaguar, the Sega Saturn. The Sega Saturn was a super powerful system. It had great first-person shooters like Power Slave and Duke Nukem and Quake. And yet, the version of Doom that was on the Sega Saturn was absolutely terrible. Sega Lord X just did a video about Saturn games that he didn't like, and I've never played the Doom version on Saturn, but that game is so crippled. Like, it's not necessarily indicative, because it's an old game, that you're gonna get a great version of the game. So to see Doom, you know, just look so good and silky smooth and just play so great is definitely, you know, it's definitely something very cool. It's definitely something I like to see, because, you know, it's a timeless game. It is a timeless classic game. So you can see that it's running great aside from the strange music. But as far as everything else is concerned, the controls are buttery smooth, the game looks great, and it plays great. So really, that's all that matters when you're playing Doom, is how it looks and plays, although the music would be nice. But this is the first level of Doom 1, so I just wanted to show you guys that real quick. Now let's check out Doom 2 and see how that works. All right, so once again, Doom 2, you have to do the same sort of stuff with airplane mode in order for it to not let you, play the game offline, but it works exactly the same. And you can see that Doom 2 is once again running great. The only problem I have with Doom 2 is once again with the music, and it's not necessarily because of the slowdown of it, but it seems like the composition is like slightly murky and it's like off a little bit. I don't know. Once again, you know, Doom 2 isn't a game that I really played a lot of. It's probably the one Doom game that I really don't have many fond memories of because I never played it. The original time, or the first time I ever played Doom, was actually at one of my dad's coworkers' house, and his son had a PC with Doom on it, and I had never even heard of Doom at that time. So to see Doom was just like something absolutely crazy to me. But I did have some people, you know, hit me up and ask me what version of Doom they should check out. And really, that's one of the things that Bethesda definitely nailed is the pricing of these games, because Doom 1 and Doom 2 are available for $5 a piece. Yes, Capcom, $5 a piece. Like, that's a ridiculously great value for just how timeless these games are and how classic these games are. So, you know, they absolutely nailed it on the pricing. Doom 3 is a bit higher at $10, but we're going to take a look at Doom 3 and see why that game is honestly worth more than $10 to me. But you can see Doom 2 is once again running great. You know, it looks great. It plays great. The music definitely needs a little bit of fixing, but you know, I can deal with that as long as the gameplay is good. And once again, the gameplay is good. Doom 2, you know, they included more weapons, they included more enemies. I think the graphics actually look a bit better than Doom 1 as well. I think a lot of people have more nostalgia for Doom 1. I know personally I do, because Doom 2 was just a game that I didn't really play all that much, you know, growing up or anything like that. I didn't have a good PC or anything, but Doom 2 is definitely a great game, definitely a game worth checking out. So now let's check out Doom 3, because that's where things actually get very interesting for me, I feel. Alright, so here is Doom 3 running on the Nintendo Switch, and you can tell by taking a look at it, this isn't a clean-cut port of the original Xbox version. This is actually an enhanced version of the game. The game looks like it's running at 1080p, and it looks very, very smooth. Like, this game actually looks very, very good, and I was actually very impressed with that. I figured at the $10 price point, it would probably be like a one-to-one replication of the original Xbox version, which is what I played way back in the day, but it's really not. Like, this game, I think, looks absolutely gorgeous. I did hear some people say that they had some problems with frame rate and things like that. I've been playing this game for about an hour. I haven't had any sort of issues with frame rate or anything like that. So I don't know if maybe in later parts of the game that becomes an issue, but this game is definitely very, very different than the first two Doom games that we just checked out. Obviously, the pace is much slower. It's essentially a first-person survival horror game set in the Doom universe. And it's definitely very different, but I really liked Doom 3 because of that. Like, look at how creepy this game is. It's just, it's very unique in the Doom sphere. And it's a game that sort of flies under the radar for a lot of people because of how different it was. And I get that, but at least at the time, Bethesda wasn't like trying to pull a bait and switch and trick you like they did with Youngblood and just throw in this completely different game. Like, you knew going into it that this game was going to be somewhat different than the original Dooms, but I'm very impressed with this game. I've been playing most of it in handheld mode, and it still looks great. This dude is tearing me up. Please reload. Oh my god, that was terrible. I think I saw a health pickup over here. Yeah, we're good. I've been playing it a lot in handheld mode. At handheld mode, it looks like it's running at 720p. Very clean, very crisp. For some reason, there's no subtitles, though, which is kind of weird. I am one of those people that, you know, I'm not super big into reading, but I do like subtitles because, oh goodness, because sometimes I feel like I miss some of the dialogue or something. So I don't know, that's kind of weird to me. You can see this dude breaking out the glass over here. This was a very advanced game when it came out. I guess I can't shoot this barrel. Oh, maybe I can, I just wasn't hitting it. This was a very advanced game when it came out, you know, especially on PC rigs and stuff. So to see it running so nicely on the Nintendo Switch, I think is great. Of course, this game does have a jump feature as well, which the previous two games in the series, Doom and Doom 2, did not. And I know what you're saying to yourself, well, there is one Doom game that is missing. We are missing Doom 64. Well, it looks like Doom 64 is actually going to be coming to the Nintendo Switch, PS4, Xbox One as well. They did a PEGI rating for this game, for Doom 64 very recently. It was the same sort of PEGI rating that we saw with Doom and Doom 2. So it does look like Doom 64 is coming to the Switch as well. I'm actually going to be very interested to see how that game ends up being, because obviously one of the problems with Doom 64 was just how dark the game was. Like, some of the areas, it was like impossible to see where you were going, and like that's not a good thing to do. You probably want to have you want to be able to see the game. It wasn't for like atmosphere or anything like that. It was just designed in a dark manner. So I definitely want to see how they end up porting that game over and how that game ends up running. But as far as what Doom you should pick up, pick up all three of them. Like, literally, it's $20 for all three of these Doom games, and like, that's just such a steal to me. Like, oh my goodness gracious. Like, look at this game. I love Doom 3. I don't care what anyone says. Yes, it's a hell of a lot slower paced than other Doom games, but it's legit, like, scary, and it's a legit survival horror-esque game, and the fact that it looks so nice and it runs so smoothly, at least for me, on the Nintendo Switch is a huge win, in my opinion. It's a game that everyone needs to check out, oh, goodness, in some way, shape, or form, because it's a classic, in my opinion, a game that doesn't get enough credit for being as good as it is. I would like to see other games, you know, from this era that were done in this style, possibly ported over to old systems. But Bethesda, you did pretty good with this game. The pricing is nice. The graphics, obviously Panic Button did this game. Panic Button are known for doing Doom and Wolfenstein on the Nintendo Switch. Panic Button, once again, a fantastic port, in my opinion, of this game. And just, it's great to have these three games on the Switch. The Switch is officially doomed, and you know what? I'm glad it's doomed. But let me know in the comments section down below if you have picked up any of the Doom games, and if so, what you think of them. Hopefully, like I said, they do some patching. They did say they were going to do some patching to fix the whole login issue with the Bethesda servers, but like I said, just throw your game in airplane mode and you're going to be fine. You won't have that issue. And as always, guys, thank you for checking out this video. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications. Be sure to check out other videos on the channel. We got some new videos that I just released. Stevie Richards came back on the channel yesterday, so make sure you guys check out that Retromania announcement for the new wrestling game coming to the Nintendo Switch. And as always, guys, I will catch you guys on the next video. Later.